Guys, welcome to our part two of our video on this 2014 Canada Outlander 1000 Max Limited. Today we're going to do the figure out why we got no brake pressure. So what we're going to do is jack up the ATV and pull all four wheels off so we can get a better look at our brake lines and our calipers.
It didn't take long to figure out why we have no brake pressure. Our right front brake line is broken off right at the caliper. I'm guessing there was probably some mud or something stuck in there and the machine wasn't washed enough and it ended up ripping it off. So we'll get a new line ordered. In the meantime, while we're waiting for that, we'll fix the rear brake line or a brake, we'll fix the rear fitting on the shock so that the air ride's working again.
Light in here, you can see we've got a remove this broken off fitting and I'll have to remove the other end off this line. You can see here our new fitting, it's brass. It's got an O-ring on it, it's a swivel fitting. Anytime I'm dealing with any suspension fittings underneath of an ATV or automotive, I like to make sure I use a little anti-seize on them because you don't want your lines seizing up should you ever have to service stuff in the future. Especially brake cylinders and stuff on cars. Put new cylinders on. You want to make sure you put a little anti-seize on the bleeder nipples, etc. Now that we've got our new fitting in there, you want to make sure that when you do tighten that line up onto the elbow that pivots, you make sure you hold that elbow so that when you're tightening this up, you're not putting too much pressure on the pivot part of the fitting. If you do not hold that, you may possibly break that off if you're torquing it up that much.
Well, now we're gonna pull this brake line out. Doesn't look like it's gonna be a whole lot of fun because on the Canadian model, the brake line with the front two brakes and the rear brake is all one piece. So we're gonna have to pull it all out in one piece, which only God knows how much plastic we're gonna have to pull off to get that yanked out. So I'll try and show you a little bit how to do that. There's a couple clamps on each side on the swing arm, and then it goes up in along the steering stem. And I guess we'll probably have to pull the seat off. Normally, if I was doing brake lines, I'd take the cap off my reservoir, loosen my brake bleeder screws, and suck all the fluid out first. But because this is broken right off, all the fluid is gone already. Now I've got both retaining clamps for the brake line pulled off, both A-arms on the front. I feel that the easiest step next is pull these six or seven plastic clips and get these inner fender wells. Behind each fender well, you're gonna find another clamp holding your brake line right behind your shock here, about halfway up your radiator. And then from the factory, you're gonna find a few zip ties and stuff. So there's absolutely no way you can pull this out without pulling your inner fender well. We're gonna have to pull the seat off, center console, and probably unclip the speedometer. We're going to pull the front rack off too. There's two bolts. One bolt on either side has a 10 mil head. One bolt on either side has a 13 mil head, which go in from the bottom. And then on the front, from the rack to the push bumper, is a Torx head bolt as well. And you have two 8 millimeter head screws that go in from the bottom holding the fender to the rack. Then you can pull it off too. And once you've got the rack off, you can flip the, I guess you call it the hood, out of the way creatively to work on. Then your speedometer housing is loose. You can just flip that forward. You might end up pulling it right out. There's two more clips, one on the front here, and these two clips on the front, on the back, just push down into the airbox housing. You can pull the airbox out of the way. This one here is full of grain, obviously because mice have been in there. Filter still looks good, but it's definitely not chewed through, it's not dirty. But we're gonna have to vacuum all this out of there before we pull the airbox off.
You can see how much grain is in this airbox. I've seen them do this very many times on farm machines.
You can see how much fun this really was not, getting this original brake line out. The original brake line is a one-piece unit. runs from your rear master to your front master to your front wheels. Here's the piece. And it's got little clamps everywhere underneath the fuel tank. So you can just imagine how nice that was to get out. Not fun. Sorry I left all the cursing out of my video. We're gonna clean this up now and get ready to put our new brake line in. I'll try to show you a little more as I put it back in. But here we go. Like we do with all our brake lines, we blow air through them first so we don't have one little piece of dirt to jam up a caliper or a master cylinder. Then, because this is one piece and it's a little bit tricky running it through a dirty quad, we're gonna pull all our clamps off so that when we're pulling them through, we don't cut any wiring. And we're gonna tape off all our fittings so that we don't get any dirt back in our line when we're pulling it through. So now that you get your brake lines back in there, you wanna make sure that everywhere that they're routing, you're back in your original saddles, no sharp points, zip ties, you wanna put your clamps back on, your main bolt for your junction lock, you wanna put that back in. We're gonna start up here at the master, put our bolts back in, our banjo bolts for the brake lines, the new crush washer so we don't have any leaks, and work our way down, tying our lines back in, and then we're gonna put our plastics back on. Put your electrical fittings here on top of your steering neck. You wanna make sure you use a little UltraSeal, like the dielectric grease. Always use that on all your connectors to keep water and dirt and moisture out. Zip ties, once again, you've heard me say before, don't put them on too tight. You want your wires to float a little bit so that they don't break, because some of these wires are very low resistance. If you start breaking wires, increase resistance, or you lose communication completely.
Your front brake line's on, get the banjo bolt in there. You want to turn your wheels both ways. Make sure you got a little slack when they're turned all the way, so it's not pulling on this elbow. Now that we have all our brake lines installed, we're going to go around and make sure that our bleeder nipples on the calipers and the bleeder nipples on our master on the rear are all loose but snug. Those are all loose. Now we're gonna go up and fill up our reservoir up top here, and we'll get these brakes bled. The top of your master cylinder is always gonna tell you what type of fluid. Don't mix them up. This machine requires .4 brake fluid. So we're gonna fill up the master. Then we're gonna turn our vacuum pump on our right front caliper and suck it through. Once you've got your brakes bled, there's no more air in them, nice and solid. Push the rubber or diaphragm from your lid back in. Make sure your lid is clean. Your lid back on. And go around right now, check all my brake lines, make sure they're still tight, nothing's rubbing, no sharp edges. Shifter. Nothing's running down here. Everything's working fine. And now we'll start putting our plastics back on. Start with the plastic piece under the seat. Then we'll put the right running board back on. And then our front fenders to cover it. Back on. you guys had as much fun watching this video as I had doing the actual work replacing that brake line. We're gonna take this machine out for a ride, clean up the shop, put away the tools, and call her a night. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and like this video and share it with your friends. And I promise you the next video is gonna be a lot better than this one.